Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about a new topic, that is thermochemical equation. This is the equation that we have did earlier also, but now we are going to mention it in a very deep manner. So let us see what is thermochemical equation. So thermochemical equation is the balanced chemical equation in which the exact value of the enthalpy change as well as the physical state as well as the number of moles of reactant and products are being specified. So basically thermochemical reaction or thermochemical equation, it states for a chemical reaction or a chemical equation in which this kinds of things like the number of moles of the reactants and the products as well as the exact value of the enthalpy change, that is how much amount of enthalpy has been changed, that is positive or negative, as well as the physical states of the reactants and the product. If this all are been mentioned in a particular reaction, that will be stated to be a chemical thermochemical equation. And in a normal equation or a normal chemical reaction, as we know, we don't mention the amount of enthalpy, but since we are talking about the thermochemistry or we are talking about chemical thermodynamics, the change in enthalpy is being necessary to mention during for a particular reaction, and so that makes a normal chemical reaction into thermochemical equation or thermochemical reaction. So before understanding that, let us see the few guidelines so as to understand, because this kind of reaction that we have did earlier also during endothermic or during exothermic reaction or heat of reaction. So let us talk about that, what are the guidelines that we should mention so as to specify what is actually thermochemical equation. So for that we have, that is, the equation must be balanced for the number of moles of reactant and product, that is sure. The first thing that we should always make sure that the equations that we have written for a particular reaction, that should be balanced with the number of moles of reactant as well as the number of moles of product. And moving towards the next one, that is, the number value and appropriate sign should be mentioned on the right hand side of the reaction. We have seen in endothermic and exothermic reaction, whenever we write a particular reaction, suppose if it has been balanced and it has an specification of these solid state, liquid or a kind of physical state that we mentioned. So after, on the right hand side, we mentioned delta H, and that delta H will have a particular value that could be positive or that could be negative. So that delta H should be written on the extreme right of a particular reaction. So this is the criteria, or this is the guideline that represent a thermochemical equation. So this was the second point. So now let us move on to the third point, and let us see that what does it ask about. It says that the physical state of the reactant and the product must be specified. The physical state of reactant and product, that is solid, liquid or gas, we always specify for a particular reactant or for a particular product that at which on which state the particular reactant or the products are, that is solid, liquid or gas. So this criteria should also be mentioned when we represent a thermochemical equation. So this was the three points that we have, but we have also more points, so let us discuss about that also. So the next point is that is the given value of the delta H naught, and in this case the delta H naught is nothing but the change in enthalpy for a reaction when it is in a standard state, or we could also say it as the standard enthalpy of reaction, assumes that the reaction occurs in the given direction. Whenever a reaction has been represented and on the extreme right of that, if delta H been represent is been mentioned having a particular value, might be positive or might be negative, so that indicates that the reaction has been followed through that process only, and that is not a backward reaction. Suppose if A plus B is giving me C plus D, and this and in that case, suppose if delta H value is informed to be, suppose plus 20 kilojoule. So in this case, this plus 20 kilojoule is indicating that this is only possible if A and B, the both are being converted into C and D. So this delta H also gives us indirectly the direction of the reaction which has been followed. And suppose if we have to reverse the reaction, that is, now if we have to convert the C plus D into A plus B, now the delta H that we had as 20 kilojoule plus 20 kilojoule, it will be negative, that is minus 20 kilojoule. So this will indicate that the reaction has been reversed. So there are a few criteria that we should mention. So this was the fourth point that was a clear indication that the delta H will give the value of the forward reaction or for the given direction of a particular reaction. So now let us move on to the next point that has that we have as for the reverse reaction, the sign of the delta H naught must be changed. So that is what I have mentioned in this example only when we are discussing about the fourth point. So for the reverse reaction, what will happen? The magnitude will remain the same. The only thing that will change is the exothermic process will become an endothermic process, or we could say vice versa. Because in this thing we have discussed earlier also, that is in heat of reaction as well as in endothermic and exothermic reaction, where if positive charge of delta H is being obtained, so this indicates that the energy is being consumed by the reaction mixture or by the system, indicating that it would be a endothermic reaction. And suppose if delta H is negative, this indicates that the energy has been released from the system, and that's why it is said to be an exothermic reaction. So this fifth point clearly indicates that suppose if we have to reverse a particular reaction, so the magnitude of that particular substance or during that reaction, the change of enthalpy will remain same, but there will be difference in the sign, negative or positive, as well as the reaction will be reversed when we are talking about exothermic or endothermic reaction. So this was the fifth point that we had. Talking about the next one, that is the last guideline that we have, that is if the coefficient indicates the number of moles of all the substance in the thermochemical equation are multiplied or divided by a number factor. So what will happen? The value of delta H naught will also be multiplied or divided by the same factor. So what does it say? Let me give an example, short example for which you could understand in a very better way. Suppose again, if I would say, suppose if I have A moles of A and suppose B moles of B, it gives C plus D. And if delta H has a value of somewhere around 20 kilojoules, suppose. Just as to make a small example so that you could understand in a better way. Suppose if in this case, if I have multiplied the stoichiometric, which is now as you could see that one each for each reactant and product, it's been one. And suppose if I have to convert for 2 moles of A, so what will happen? The soon I multiply the stoichiometry coefficients by 2, each and every one will be multiplied by 2 so as to balance the reaction. So it is fine. But what would be for the value of delta H? Again, this value of delta H or delta H naught that we have, it should also be multiplied by 2. Or if we divide, suppose if we divide the stoichiometry by any particular number like 4, so even this delta H naught should be divided by 4. So that is what this point number 6 is being mentioning. So this clearly indicates that we should concern this guidelines so as to represent a thermodynamical equation or thermochemical equation. So ultimately a last example so as to make you sure that what we have did in our earlier lecture, that was fine. That is, I have taken this example. So this example has that is OF2 that is present in gaseous state, it will react with water so as to form O2 plus 2 times HF, that is hydrogen fluoride. So the delta H naught in this case is minus 3 to 3 kilojoule. So the reaction is been mentioned here, and what we have did is we have on the extreme right side, because I didn't have space to write here, so for that instance I have mentioned here. So this delta H should be mentioned at the extreme right of that particular reaction itself. So this will indicate that the what would be the change of enthalpy during the reaction, or what is the enthalpy of the reaction of a particular reaction that we have, as well as you could see here, the number of value is also been mentioned for the H, as well as we could see that it is be minus. So this clearly indicates that the energy is being evolved from the system or from the reaction, which makes this reaction to be exothermic because the delta H value is negative. So, and as well as the number of moles or the stoichiometry is also being balanced in this case. As you could see, the fluorine has been present 2 times on the reactant side, while on the product side is also been 2 times of fluorine that we have when it comes to an atomic state. So this clearly indicates that the thermodynamic chemical equation or thermochemical equation should be represented with a few guidelines that we have. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this concept very clearly, and this will be very much beneficial in solving a numericals or to understand a particular thermochemistry of a particular reaction. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.